Not long ago, we did a ChargerLAB Compatibility 100 test for the brand new iPhone 15 Pro Max. Many of you guys want to get a detailed charging review for this phone. So today, let's go ahead and test it. Take out the phone from the box. We received the blue version with a storage capacity of 256GB. Apart from the phone itself, it also includes a new dual USB-C cable, but the charger is not included. The diameter is 3.17 mm, and the length is about 1 meter. Our ChargerLAB Power ZKM003C shows it does not have any eMarker chip. It means the supported power won't exceed 60 watts. The most critical change of the iPhone 15 Pro Max is definitely the USB-C port. That's also what ChargerLAB cares about. It can support USB 3 with speeds of up to 10 gigabits per second and reverse charging. You can charge your Apple Watch, AirPods, and even the other iPhone. Next, let's begin our tests. Start from the compatibility test. We tested all the Apple fast chargers we have. The charging power is stable at around 25 to 26 watts, which is the same as the previous generation. Since Apple 29 watts can trigger the 14.5 volts, it can reach the highest power. As for third-party chargers, the charging power is also stable at around 25 to 26 watts. For more details, you can click the upper right corner to view the compatibility 100 test for this phone. Next, we'll use the Apple 35 watts dual USB-C charger to fully charge the iPhone 15 Pro Max. The voltage is around 9 volts at first. The charging curve can be divided into 5 parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 26 watts for the first 22 minutes. Then the power gradually drops to 22 watts, 15 watts, and 8.6 watts in turn. The final part begins at 52 minutes and the voltage drops to 5 volts. It takes 1 hour and 55 minutes to be fully charged. We also turn it into another curve. It can charge the iPhone 15 Pro Max to 50% in 25 minutes, and it can reach 80% in 51 minutes, 100% in 1 hour and 55 minutes. The last 20% took more than half of the time. Crazy. Then we switch to the Apple 70 watts charger to see how it performs. The charging curve is quite similar to the 35 watts. All critical power turning points are basically the same as before. It takes 1 hour and 48 minutes to be fully charged. When charging with 70 watts charger, the curve shows that only the last 20% is about 7 minutes faster than the 35 watts charger, a minor improvement. We also put the phone into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank throughout the test, and we recorded the highest temperatures on the front and back at 3 different time points. After 10 minutes of charging, the highest temperature on the front is 36.1 degrees Celsius, the back is slightly higher at 38 degrees Celsius. After 30 minutes, the highest temperature on the front increased to 37.1 degrees Celsius, and the back is 38.9 degrees Celsius. Surprisingly, after 60 minutes, the highest temperature on the front dropped to 29.3 degrees Celsius, and the back is 29.5 degrees Celsius. From this bar graph, the highest temperature is about 38 degrees Celsius at 30 minutes. According to the full charging test, the phone was in fast charging mode at that time, after charging for 60 minutes and switching to trickle charging mode. As the voltage and power decrease, so does the temperature. Well, that's all charging tests we did for iPhone 15 Pro Max. It's compatible with almost all third-party PD chargers, but the charging speed has not improved. And the highest temperature during charging is similar to your body temperature. After switching to USB-C, it supports recharge functions like DP, reverse charging, external drive, etc. We will continue to make videos for you to better understand the USB-C port of iPhone 15 series. You can leave your comments down below to tell us what you want to see. And don't forget to drop a like and subscribe to us if you like this video. See you in the next video. Bye!